Okay, hello everybody, this is going to be an achievement hunt for Dark Elven Legacy. It has two stacks, Xbox and Windows, both have been provided to me by Old School Vibes. I'm playing this specific video on the Windows version, so let's get on with it, let's start the clock. We have to complete all 30 levels, get the gems, go through, that's basically it. And Dwaggy, you may be asking, why are you getting hit by all the slimes? Because I'm a lazy git who literally cannot be asked to shoot all of the slimes if I can get away with going away from them. Spikes are insta-kill. Spikes are insta-kill, I should say. We have 5 health segments, so on some of the levels you can literally just go through all the enemies. You can get a checkpoint as well, which will save all of the things that you have. So you can literally just speedrun through the majority of the levels. I said we are against the clock here, so that is what I'm doing. The red spikes will shoot at you. The red spikes are, as I said, insta-kill. Touching the white spikes is also an insta-kill. That was lucky. And these platforms have some horrific collision detection where they will detect you hitting the sides of them, but they won't detect you trying to go through the bottom of them, which doesn't make sense. Which means sometimes it will throw you off down the side because the game thinks you didn't make contact with it, even though you clearly did. What a shot that was. Oh, and the spikes can go through platforms. I forgot to tell you that. So this game, as I said earlier, has been provided to me by Old School Vibes, so thank you to them. See, that's what I meant about the side of the platform being solid, but the undersides of the platform not being so. See, that's exactly what I mean right there. Oh, how did I get away with that? I think I iframed that, you know. Missed time I jumped there. Thank you. Oh, shit puffins. Thought I was going to avoid that. Clearly, I thought wrong. Speed running. When you don't need to be careful and you've got 5 health segments. And you got checkpoints that will remember what you've done. Oh, I nearly got away with that as well. What was that, Dwaggy? Right, speed it then. That's how we're gonna... What the hell? Don't know if anybody saw that, but it looked like I held onto the ground from below it then. It's like I went through the floor. Go check... rewind and just see. You'll see what I mean. That was a mispress. I meant to press 30G, but it added 35. No problem. We'll just add 20, 25 on this next one, and that'll even it out. This guy needs to fuck right off. Oh, I did not hit that spike. I pulled away from that. Thank you. Well, I fucked that up, didn't I? So I notice on these some of these levels, if you get the flag and then get a collectible after getting the flag, it'll still remember that you got the collectible even after, even though you're being walked to a flag that you hit afterwards, if that makes sense. You can kind of exploit that. As long as you can get to the next bit within 5 hits, it's exploitable. Like that. Of course, if you don't get to a place where you can't hit a goddamn flag. So you can't see it, but behind my camera, when I pick up an item, it says equipped, but they've only spelt it with one P. because people don't know how to spell check, apparently. Good jump, Dwaggy. Good jump. Credit to the team. Thank you. Where the hell did I miss one then? Oh, up there. Oh, for fuck's sake, that's twice I've hit that fucking red spike. Stop the clock. G in 30 minutes 18 seconds. Thank you everybody for watching. Thank you Old School Vibes for providing the code. We'll see you next time.